Hey guys, Krisky here. As you can see, I'm once again in my sketchy basement because in every other room in my house there's someone doing something. So I picked the quietest room, even though there's some background noise. I hope you can't hear that. But anyway, so today is the first official really vlog that I'm actually going to be talking about anything on this channel, CriskysCorner. I'm hoping to do this every day. And the idea for this, I posted on my Tumblr, which will be linked down below. I just asked what should my topic for today's vlog be. And the Green Fairy, who I will link to their blog, I'll put a link right here to the Green Fairy. And I'll put a link to mine right here. Anyway, check them out. Great blog over there. We'll check both out. Mine, theirs. Green Fairy said... Here's exactly what they said. I've never seen your vlog, but maybe on self-acceptance and self-love for a happier existence? But I really like that idea because that actually really hits home with me. I don't know if you guys probably don't know this, but I have kind of had roughness. I mean, I know I live in suburbia and whatever, and I'm just a teenager, so it's... kind of sounds like, oh my god, such an emo kid. But no, I am a bisexual, not just for popular, like, I've actually dated and been in love with guys, and I'm currently dating and in love with a girl, but that's besides the point. So, in an extremely Christian family, not that I'm ripping on the religion, which generally doesn't accept homosexuality. In fact, my mom still says all kinds of stuff, like, you know, you need to find a girlfriend, she emphasizes a girlfriend, and I always say person, I need to find a person. Like, people need to find people, not necessarily a girl, not necessarily a guy. That's besides the point. I also, for a long time, was a cutter, because, you know, it helped release the adrenaline or whatever. I cut on my legs, not on my wrists, so no one else could see. That was a really personal vlog. Wow, first day, I'm getting personal with you guys. Also, when I was a small child, I was diagnosed with an optic nerve tumor on my right eye. Which basically means I can't see with it, and that's why I usually wear my hair like this. Because sometimes it wanders, it's not being too bad today, but sometimes it wanders completely blind. I went through about 2 years of chemotherapy from the ages 3 till about the age 6. So I had no hair, it was horrible. And I was always sick for that time. And, you know, as I got older, you know, everyone was always telling me, you know, whatever, you're loved, whatever. But as I got into high school, I moved during my freshman year of high school to New York from Florida. I move a lot. Every time I move, I had to start over. And so I kind of got used to being lonely because you always, when you move, you have no friends for a little while. I had no friends for my first summer here. And, you know, it kind of put me into a little bit of a depression. And I still struggle with depression from that. I don't have a lot of friends, like, in real life. You know, I always have my girlfriend and whatnot. But, she's actually out of town, and I haven't left my house since Friday when I had school. Or Thursday when I had school. I didn't have school Friday. But anyway, that's besides the point. So, you really need to realize that people... I've noticed this a lot in other people as well. That if you don't accept who you are... if you don't accept yourself, you're not going to be able to be happy. Like, I think I'm happy-ish. I mean, I still struggle with depression sometimes. But one of the biggest parts of me coming out of depression and being able to, you know, have a good relationship with a couple other people was the fact that I had to realize that, sure, I'm a little different. Sure, I'm, you know, I'm attracted to both males and females. Sure, I do some kind of nerdy things, you know. Obviously, I have a whole channel dedicated to Yu-Gi-Oh! On YouTube. You know, I'm not like everybody else, and I speak my mind. And I really had to get used to the fact that, okay, so I had to accept that people were gonna make fun of me for being gay or, well, bi. But to a lot of people at my school, bi equals gay. That's besides the point. You know, that was the biggest hurdle I had to get over for the whole depression thing. That ties into this self-acceptance whatnot. So, yeah, you can't be happy without understanding and loving yourself. This kind of sounds rambly and really poorly scripted, because I didn't script it at all. I don't know what else to say. I mean, I'm obviously mostly over my depression. I mean, it comes back every once in a while. And I got over it without medication or anything, because I accepted that things probably weren't going to change. And, that sucks. But the part about self-acceptance is, first, you know, I met a lot of, confrontation with friends, and especially with my family, especially with my mother. My dad doesn't seem to care, but my mom especially, with the whole gay thing. I had to be like, listen, I don't care what other, bi thing, I keep saying gay, whatever. See, I'm in that mentality too, bi equals gay, even though I date girls as well, but whatever. That's besides the point. So, I really had to accept that about myself, and it took a lot of soul-searching, I think, because, first of all, I knew I was bi for the longest time, but I went to a Christian school and got kicked out, and that was the whole thing, and so I didn't want to come out, I didn't want to do anything else to make my parents disappointed, but then eventually, I told some friends, and then I told my family last year, and when I told them, sure, now they give me a hard time about it, but at the same time, it felt good to get it off my chest, whatever. You need to accept yourself and tell other people. You can't just say, oh yeah, I accept I'm this way, but I'm gonna keep it hidden. You need to accept yourself and your own, like, you need to accept yourself, you need to love yourself, and you need to show it to other people. You need to show other people that you're confident enough. And I think that's the steps. You need to accept yourself. After you accept things about yourself, or even with other people too, you need to accept things about them, you need to love things about them, and that's how you're going to be happy. That's all I really have to say on this topic. You know, I don't know what else to say. I'm kind of rambling and going in circles at this point. Please comment, like the video, whatever. Comment if you have a similar experience. Comment, whatever. Private message me or email me at contactcrisky@gmail.com. I'll put the email address below. If you have a topic that you want me to cover, or if you have anything you want to talk to me about, public or not, I'll have my Tumblr down below, I'll have the person who suggested this topic down below, and over here. I'll put their link up right here again, and my Tumblr link right here. And I'm sorry for the light in the background over there. Sorry, my camera's... Anyway. So yeah, rate, comment, subscribe. I hope you like this. Like I said, I'm here. Thanks. Till next time, guys.